his presentations about the effects of media and technology on sport, mainly football. The media is a mass form of communication, whether that's through the internet, and television, newspaper, or any other sort of written or verbal form of communication. Media coverage of sport is widespread, either by listening to commentators, pundits, or watching replays on shows such as Match of the Day or Football League Show. Participation in sports covered by the media is always higher than for those that are not. A lot of TV cameras at football matches, also there for like the live show, shows after like Match of the Day, and just sort of any other special show really. There's positive effects that the media have on sport. TV can have a positive effect as it allows more of the fan base to view the sport, which can also help increase participation in the sport. Social networking can have a positive effect on the sport as clubs can interact with the fans and other fans can interact with the fans as well as the players. It just makes it sort of a bit more closer. Can have positive effects such as like rule changes, the pass back rule was introduced. This is a stop time wasting in the game. It's effective, makes the sport sort of more interesting as the players have to concentrate more on this. Obviously the keeper can't pick it up. It can also have negative effects as a TV can say if they want to view it. It can have an effect on kickoff times. For example, in the World Cup, they had to change times of the kickoff so that more people could view the match around the world. This happened to be at the hottest time of the day, which sort of made it harder for the players. Social networking can have a negative effect as players can sort of get abuse on that, which can affect their confidence, and they can sort of post inappropriate comments which can land them a hefty fine or suspension from the club. It can also affect attendances at matches because if more people can watch the game at home, then they're less likely to sort of go to the ground and pay to watch it. And sports personalities may also feel like their privacy is being invaded as there can be a lot of demand from the press for information and stuff like that. Technology in sport has changed a lot through the years. For example, the clothing the kits are made out of, they're made out of a different material which is lighter and can help, it stops players from overheating and it also helps retain heat, and they're referred to as thermals. You can also get chips in your football boots which help, it says, it's got your distance that you've ran within the match, the speed that you've run, so your top speed and stuff like that. Also the amount of calories that you've burned. This can then be transferred onto a computer where it can be analysed and compared to other players and previous matches. And so it can work out room for improvement and development and stuff. Goal line technology was introduced to help referees. It works with cameras within the frame of the goal that detect the positioning of the ball, whether it's over the line or not. Also, vanishing spray is introduced, which is just a spray that disappears after a minute or so, which allows the ref to make sure that the wall is the correct distance away from the ball. Football boots over the years have become lighter, stronger and more durable, allowing players to be lighter on their feet. The increased amount of cameras that are viewing the game allow for more instances to be filmed. For example, if an incident happens off the ball that you may not see in real time, they can go back and view it after the match and the referee can view it and hand out the correct punishment. Also, you can get certain player cams which just films individual players that pundits and coaches can use for stuff like play and performance and just sort of review where they've gone wrong and what they can improve. And then technology can also aid in the recovery of players. For example, the hyperbaric chamber is a chamber that a player can get into where there's an increased level of oxygen, which increases the pressure and helps remove oxygen debt from the body quicker, and lactic acid actually means that also. And that's everything.
Brilliant, well done. Right, in your opinion then, what do you think the effects are on technology, a positive or negative effect on football?
I believe overall it's a positive effect. Stuff like goal line technology and the vanishing spray allows for a fairer play and fewer mistakes.
Okay, do you think the effects of technology aid the media?
Yes. Well, if there was less technology, then there'd be more sort of discussions about, say, whether the ball crossed the line or not, which the media could benefit from, as they could make more stories out of it and stuff like that. So it affects the media in that way, but it also affects it as it's fairer because, well, the decision is the correct one at the end of the day.
Yeah. Okay, brilliant. Out of the social media, your Twitter, your Facebook and everything like that, do you think they have positive or negative effects?
I think it depends on the individual really, how disciplined they are on it. Because at the end of the day, it's what you sort of post on there, which can land you in trouble if you post rubbish. But if you just use it correctly, then
yeah. Okay. Well, how did you find using Prezi?
It's different to PowerPoint. It allows you to do more stuff. But overall, I thought it was good.
Yeah. Right. Development point from your presentation.
Pardon?
A development point. I think you need to
just sort of less blocks of text.
Yeah. Okay. I thought you presented it really well, to be fair. Some good pictures. Some of the information was a little bit too much, as in like loads of writing,
yeah.
But you still explained it well. And there's just a couple of typos, but that's just been really, really picky. That was good. Well done.